Hello and welcome to Storytime. For this month in Black History, I will be sharing children's stories, how to say hello and goodbye in one language per week, and things that are Black. But also, for this month only, I will be sharing something extra. There's a book by Jabari Asim titled A Child's Introduction to Black History. I will be sharing one or two pages or three a day of this book until it is completed at the end of the month. I hope that you subscribe to my channel and that you tune in every day for an exciting read and to be educated about Black history. Stay tuned. And now, let's practice saying hello in sign language. Shelton Jackson, Spike Lee, is an African-American film director, producer, writer, and actor. His production company, 40 Acres and a Mule Filmworks, has produced more than 35 films since 1983. Please, Baby, Please, by Spike Lee and Tonya Lewis Lee. Illustrated by Kader Nelson. Go back to bed, baby, please. Not on your head, baby, please. Keep off the wall, baby, please. You share that ball, please, baby. Don't eat the sand, baby, please. Now hold my hand, baby, please. It's time to go, please. Don't be so slow, baby, please. Please eat your peas, baby. Don't be a tease, baby, please. Please don't splash, baby, please. No, in the trash, baby. Now you sleep tight. Please, baby, please. Kiss me goodnight. Mama, please. The beginnings of slavery, kidnapped or traded. Most groups that immigrate to the United States leave their homelands in search of a better life. African Americans are the only ethnic group whose ancestors were brought to this country against their will. White colonists bought them as if they were property. Then they transported them to the New World. Whether traded by enemy tribes or kidnapped by European raiders, Africans were herded into slave camps on the west coast of Africa starting in the 1500s.
If they managed to survive the disease and misery of the camps, they took their last steps on African soil at places like the Doorway of No Return on Gori Island in Senegal and Elminya in Ghana. Over the course of three centuries, armed traders forced 20 million Africans onto ships to transport them across the Atlantic Ocean to European colonies in the Americas and the Caribbean. Once there, they had to plant and tend crops for long hours with no pay. The Middle Passage. Before reaching the colonies, African captives had to endure the Middle Passage. It was called this because it was the middle part of a trade triangle that had three legs. The first brought goods from Europe to the African coast, where they were exchanged for human captives. The second leg extended from Africa to the Americas, where the enslaved men and women were traded for raw materials to take on the third leg, which was the return trip to Europe. After having identifying marks burned into their skin with branding irons, the Africans were shackled together and packed by the hundreds into tiny spaces beneath the decks of the ships. The compartments were unbearably hot, crowded, and stuffy. Many captives died during the Middle Passage due to suffocation, starvation, or sickness. Historians believe that between 10% and 20% of the captives did not survive the journey. Journey to Jamestown. Most enslaved Africans were transported to Brazil and the Caribbean islands, such as Haiti and Cuba. The first to arrive in the British North American colonies came to Jamestown, Virginia in 1619. Brought in to help grow tobacco and corn, some came directly from Africa, while others had already spent time elsewhere in North or South America. Working the soil with long-handled hoes, they often labored alongside indentured servants. White immigrants who had agreed to work for a set period in exchange for free or discounted passage across the Atlantic. During the colonial era, 1607 to 1776, tobacco plantations in Virginia and Maryland had the most enslaved people. Many other slaves were forced to work on rice and indigo, a crop that makes blue dye, plantations in South Carolina. For the first 50 years or so of Africans' time in the colonies, there were no official laws designating them as property. Still, slaves lived in harsh conditions and were often cruelly mistreated. As the use of enslaved Africans for manual labor spread through the colonies, their tasks expanded beyond field work to include skilled crafts. In places like the Carolinas, Louisiana, and New York, black people were assigned carpentry, blacksmithing, and wheelmaking jobs.
And now, let's practice saying goodbye in sign language.